What's up, everybody out there in YouTube land? Wrath2501 here. Okay, guys, we are returning back to Kaperuku Studios for the mind part of Double Feature Friday. All right, this is Engineer's Portal Part 2. This is Episode 4, Betrayal. And we all have seen the Portal games and the other mind search, Chell's mind, and whatnot. We know what's going to happen here, okay? We know what happens in Portal and Portal 2, you know? Let's see. Of course, this is by Kaperuku Studios, formerly known as HiGamer808. Awesome guy. And let's see what he's got for us here. And go.
Last time on Engineer's Portal Part 2.
Previously on Engineer's Portal.
Redemption line?
In a typical Aperture Science fashion, the functionality of this section is relatively simple. In this case, a conveyor to an incinerator, given a jazzed up and ironic name.
Assholes.
That's interesting. So what's the plan then?
It's severed, not severe.
To drop to dangerously unlethal levels.
Whee! Yeah! They told me it wasn't fun. I know.
Yeah.
Oh. I mean, while Wheatley started off as kind of an idiot, he seemed like a pretty cool guy at first, you know? Until, you know, his narcissism and insanity kicked in. Written and produced. That's the room you were in when you started.
GLaDOS might not have any cores on her for us to destroy, and I doubt that she'll make the same mistake as before. Although, what can she do now that she's stripped from her turrets and neurotoxin gas?
I don't know, all I can say.
GLaDOS emergency shutdown and cake.
Here we go.
Dispensary. Keep unlocked. Well, I mean, like, seriously, where else can you go? Is it one's on fire, one's a box?
Engineer, it's working.
What's wrong? No turrets, GLaDOS. Just in time.
You could have walked right through that glass, considering how gently Wheatley tapped it and it just shattered. It was already cracked. Why are you asking the corrupted core? Leave me in. Stay, mate.
You all about to have a really bad day.
Oh. Stalemate associate.
Damn it.
Oh, press the button. Just like that.
Say goodbye, GLaDOS.
She can't just put them all up at the same time. Damn, that is still brutal.
Well done, Wheatley.
Gotta say, that was too easy.
Yeah. Oh, jeez. Can't even talk, dude.
You son of a bitch.
Damn. Yeah. You. Yep, that would be him. You're the best moron that could be designed by science. There you go. There are several jokes I can make there about politics, but I won't, okay? Get all the way the hell down there. Look like a mile underground.
I want to die. Where are we?
I don't know. We must be somewhere deep underground. I don't seem to recognize this area of aperture.
Well, here we are. Gotta find a way back up.
It's the old salt mine.
Son of a bitch.
That made it. Made it the foundation.
Us.
He's nuts.
Because he thinks he's the king around here. I mean, well, he did took over Gladys's spot, and now watching over, now taking over the entire aperture science facility.
The dialogue is kind of tripping over itself a bit here.
Anything.
He probably can't even see you.
If we ever do return back to the surface, he would know where we are and what we're doing, and he won't have anything to do about that. It's fine. Just don't think too hard. I think I might need help depending on the situation, but you just remember, I'm right here if you need to talk. Okay?
Okay.
This is really cool about this game. This is what I do love about it, is these massive, ancient, you know, structures built deep, deep underground that people built on top of and forgot about. It's like New York. You can actually find a lot of old shit deep down under in the tunnels under New York, New York City. They go on for miles under the city, under the river.
Who the hell's calling now?
Oh, good. Finally, I found your boat. I don't seem to know where you are, but so you survived that high of a fall, huh? Now I wonder where you and that little twat.
Wheatley, you eyeball-looking son of a bitch. You betrayed us.
Oh, I did no such thing. You and that little twat of yours were the ones that betrayed me, as I said before. All you both were selfish. Who planned all of this? Me, tiny, little. Wheatley did this.
find you and start tearing you apart one by one.
Spare me the threats, Conagher. I was the one that came up with the plan to take out GLaDOS and run this whole entire place, but you just cared for yourself. It was my plan. My plan!
Yeah, you came up with most of
it. Interesting, he's giving him more dialogue here.
Doing all the work and was being your little pawns. Me and Cheryl. We did all the work.
You
did nothing but just gloat, you treacherous snake.
Really, tell me the truth. Why would you do this?
Why do you think Cheryl? Because I can. I'm tired of being a moron and an idiot, but now I run Aperture and you both are nothing but pest rats out there thinking you are so better than me. Now don't play dumb with me, Cheryl. I know you said all those things behind my back. I know everything about you.
But me and Engineer didn't do anything to you.
You both would have, if I'd given you the chance.
Dude.
As soon as I find you, as soon as I get out of this dump, I'm gonna tear you apart one by one. You better mark my words on that, boy.
I'd like to see you try, mate. You both enjoy yourself down there while you still can.
Goddamn snake!
Oh, okay, that's what he was trying to do. Yeah, you gotta use that one to launch yourself. Ooh! Damn!
Huh? What are you talking about, Cheryl?
You'll know when the test starts, all of that.
Who the hell is Daddy? Is this man talking in the speaker? Who the hell is that anyway?
Cave Johnson.
Cave Johnson, the CEO and founder of Aperture Science. He is the one who made Aperture.
Cheryl.
Wait. Shower curtain salesman of 1943? Aperture Fixtures.
Chill. Keep calling that picture of that voice dead.
Spirit of Idaho, National Potato Board, for the promotion of potato science, 1955.
Now, who is that person? How do you know
him? U.S. Department of Defense, Contractor of the Year. Runner-up, 1952. And U.S. Department of... That's still defense. Yeah, that's defense. Contractor of the Year, runner-up, 1954.
I don't know what's going on.
He lost to Black Mesa.
The moment I heard his voice from the speakers there, and while I've been gone...
By salt mine. He sits in the chair.
You became a machine after all this time.
A digitized consciousness. Somebody busted into that and took all the trophies out of there.
I was made of C-167, a core that supported GLaDOS. But a long time ago, I got flashes, and somehow I saw images of my own, and soon I became self-aware.
Oh, portal gun. Cheryl is Chell.
Petroglyphs we saw when the giant painting of a woman. You're saying that they look like you? How could this be possible? We, how the hell can all of this be possible?
I don't even know. Who am I?
Hey. It's okay. It's okay, Cheryl. Everything will be fine. All I know is that if that girl in the painting was you, these flashes are coming too.
I'm actually kind of curious about the end of this, you know, how they usually show them putting in the body. I wonder if they're going to put her... I haven't seen the end of it, because I think it's over already. But I wonder if they're going to put her in a Mimi Century body.
Yes, you could say I'm kind of curious to know what the hell did Aperture do to you to turn you into a machine. But better yet, how are you somehow related to this Cave Johnson? Cave Johnson really is your father. Goodness knows who is your mother. It's all in all. I don't care how long it takes.
Woo-hoo! Whoosh.
If we're going to be reminiscing the
past,
I'll be with you every step of the way. I'll keep my promise to you on that. Okay? Just keep aware. Everything will be fine.
Aww.
I know you all should. I know. It's okay to be scared. There's no harm in that. But you don't have to be scared no more. I won't be leaving you. I won't leave you until we escape this hellhole. I promise you that. Okay?
Okay, engineer. I trust you.
Thanks, Cheryl. We'll get through this. We will survive. We always did. Down that.
I will survive. That end is actually kind of heartwarming. Okay. So this is developing pretty interesting. I do like the added bits that he's putting in, even the extra dialogue with Wheatley. I kind of like that. He's fleshing out the story a bit more. And they're explaining why they saw the picture, how they explained the painting of Chell in the thing down there. So that was pretty cool. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this. I did. Like this video, subscribe. Definitely, come on guys, click on the link to the original. Subscribe to Kapru Crew Studios. And check out his shit there. He does good work. I will see you guys next time. Tune in every day for new content. Bye-bye.